You can think about a research experiment in the lab, like creating a new cake recipe. In the kitchen, just like in your lab, you have to figure out which ingredients you need, how much of each, and the best processes to use to get the job done safely and with a great outcome. Sure, there are lots of rules that apply to what you're doing, but you can't turn to a recipe book for all your steps. After all, you're doing something new. Yes, in your lab, your chemistry knowledge, experience, and critical thinking will help you, but you also need well-organized information about hazards and tools to assess risks from these hazards. Having excellent data and a clear risk assessment will not only make your experiment safer, it will make it much easier to publish and replicate your work in the future. It's just good science. FAIR and RAMP are two acronyms that can help organize this part of your work. FAIR data principles help you figure out if you have high-quality data that are findable, for you and for others, accessible, available to everyone, interoperable, not specific to one product and can be interpreted for your needs, and reusable, so others know where it comes from and that it's real science, not fake news. It's not enough to look in the usual online sources. Try a public safety data source like safety data sheets or laboratory chemical safety summaries from the National Library of Medicine to gather and organize the data you need. Then it's time to mix your batter by combining the data you found into a risk assessment that describes your safety precautions built around the RAMP template. RAMP guides you to recognize hazards, assess risks, minimize the risks of hazards, and prepare for emergencies. Do a full risk analysis using your chemical properties and data and thinking critically about how that data interacts with your specific process and variables. It's done, which means you'll take your RAMP assessment and review it to improve your experimental planning, safety controls, and thinking through emergency procedures. And here's one last very important step. Share your recipe with your colleagues, including your risk assessment and lessons learned. After all, safety data isn't intellectual property. Making safety data transparent and accessible is important for all chemists. More and more, publishers and peers expect you to document your risk assessment process in a way that others can appreciate and use. And believe me, your future self will thank you for clearly recording your data instead of thinking you'll remember. So make notes and share your own data. Fairly contribute to lessons learned and help build our community database of safety information.